word fluff, and that just really fit in there. It's like, you know, there's many reasons we hear but don't listen. Maybe we're hearing something we don't want to hear. Or maybe we're not hearing something we want to hear. Whether we want to admit it or not, we usually have an agenda, you know. God, I have this problem and this problem, and I think you should solve it this way. God, because I wouldn't want to go that way. I'm not hearing anything from God. He got me a good one the other day. And I just recently had to hire another employee, and that's a tough thing for me to, you know, go through. I had like 3 applicants, and it's like, okay, which one, God? You know, and I have a tendency to follow the pattern. I was like, okay, God owns the bakery, and they're his employees, and so you're going to tell me which one to hire, right? That's the formula. Let's trust the formula. No. Okay. All right. Doesn't work that way, that's for sure. No. I can be honest, I wasn't 100% about any one of the 3, you know? So it's like, okay, I don't really need to hear you, God, because we're down to countdown time, and I need an employee, you know? So she came in, and she kind of showed some perseverance, you know, and I thought, okay. And I felt in my spirit, it was just a real short little thing. It's like, all right, she wants to be here. So I asked her a bunch more questions, and we went through another interview process, and then I ended up hiring her. And then I had my doubts and my second thoughts. And, okay, God, I really need to hear you. You know, I just want to be as sure as I was about the last one or the one before that, when I was so sure. And as I was walking out the back door, God said, "Were you so sure about the last one?" What? Well, sure I was. What about this and this and this? You weren't so sure about that, were you? What about the one before that? Were you really so sure about that one? I'm like, oh yeah, well, I forgot about that. All right, God, I just have to trust you. Because I wasn't so sure about the last. I don't know. Was there ever one that I was sure about?
Isn't it interesting, though, you talking to God about the, which one should I hire? That didn't even seem to. God's talking to you about you.
Yeah.
Perceptions and expectations.
It's not like it really. I don't know. That wasn't his primary agenda.
No,
all of a sudden he pipes up it opens up in a different way.
Well, because you're depending on your expectations.
Yeah. Well, you said, you know, listening is like a water dripping on a rock instead of a sledgehammer. I want the sledgehammer. I just want him to. That is it, right there. Boom. No questions asked. No doubts. No. Yeah. That's yeah. But yeah, it's not how he. He's a drip on. He's a drip on the rock.
He's a dripper, isn't he?
But Jesus stayed up all night choosing the 12, and I'm sure he had second thoughts.
Yeah. Oh, he had to have. I mean,
true.
Goodness gracious. I mean,
I'm thinking, why did
I have not had the reader say that.
Why did he have to pray all night? Why did Jesus have to pray all night?
Oh, it's another sermon topic.
Yeah,
I mean, didn't he hear Peter?
Didn't he hear right on with Peter?
Well, I don't know. We need to. I need to pray more.
That's good.
I mean,
too, they say when you rearrange the letters of listen, it's silent.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Okay.
Exactly.
Rearranging the letters
of listen,
and it spells silent.
Silent. Same letters, yeah.
I never heard that one.
So, listening,
you know,
takes silence.
Maybe you're putting too much on in the hiring process, too, because you're depending on expectations and perceptions.
You got me thinking about Mary Poppins. The guy said, "I'm going to hire the next housekeeper, nanny, whatever. This is ridiculous. You hire them all the time. We're going to do it this way." And he had 30,000 applicants coming through there. The kids came in, Daddy, this is our list of things we want. We want them to smell like barley water and different things like that, you know? And so the kids went out, you know, he kind of, okay, well, you go on out. He took the thing and just tore it up, threw it in the fireplace, and then he went on with his business. And then here comes Mary Poppins. All the other ladies are all blown away by this wind. And she comes in there and goes, she starts going through the list. She has the list, you know, got sucked up to Jimmy. It's all put together. She starts reading out, I'm never cross. I'm never, you know, I do this, and I, you know, go there. And he's remembering what the kids, he's going around and looking in the party. He goes, you know, the list isn't your list.
That's true. That's good. You know,
Dick Van Dyke. But, but the thing is, you think about it, you know, when Solomon went to get one of the kids, he went right down, oh, here's, you know, he's nice and tall, strong. You know, he went down, do you have any more, you know? It's like, no, there he is. And Pipsqueak comes in there, and just, it was a different, he had his list in mind.
Yeah.
He had his own preconcept list,
Samuel.
You know?
Samuel.
Samuel came to Jesse's house. He wasn't even part of the procedures.
But the first king he had was Saul. And he was the people's king, because that's what they want. And after God says, no, now I'm going to give you the kingdom I want. And he's going to be